Amen. And we're going to study today something very, very important. Okay, and it's very important for us to know what God has in store for us, what God is speaking in our lives. And I was praying the other day, I was saying, Lord, what is it that you want to speak to the church? And God showed me something from a verse which I like to share with you, and that is from Romans chapter 10. Let's all open our Bibles to Romans chapter 10, verse 1 and 2. I'll read that. Romans chapter 10, verse 1 and 2. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they may be saved. For I bear them witness that they have a zeal for God, but not according to knowledge. We'll not go in much detail. The content is very clear over here. Where Paul is writing about the people of Israel. And Paul is saying to them, is that, you know what, you're blessed, you're chosen, that's good. And you know, they've got a lot of zeal to do something for God. But Paul is arguing the point over here, what is the use of your zeal if there is no knowledge of God along with zeal? You see, very important for us to know today what as a child of God we need to have to move on in our walk of life. In fact, I read somewhere, it says over here that zeal without knowledge, knowledge without zeal, both not good. It's like I do something but know nothing. I do something but know nothing. The other scenario is I know something but do nothing. What is this? So what, first I do something and know nothing. I know something and do nothing. It is equivalent to zeal without knowledge, knowledge without zeal. Pick up Proverbs chapter 19 verse 2. Just a little bit, we'll just go to the basic before we get into the main content. Proverbs 19 verse 2. If somebody gets that, read it loud.
Also that soul be without knowledge is not good, and he that has within with his feet sinneth.
Hallelujah. What does it say over there? It says in a different version, being excited about something is not enough. You must also know what you are doing. Don't rush into something or you might do it wrong. It's a different version from the Bible. It says in 92 in the NKJV, and it is not good for a soul to be without knowledge, and he sins who hastens with his feet. Amen. Are you excited today? Look at each other and say, I'm excited. Today God is going to stir up your spirit. God is going to do something in you. Because right from the Old Testament to the New Testament, God picked up people and stirred up their spirit for it. Whenever God chooses and picks up people, you see, God just doesn't pick you up and say, okay, come on, go. God will put charismatic power in you. Chisel is something. You know, you burn coal. When you do coal, when you burn coal, it's just not enough just to put the fire there, right? A lot of efforts are there. Sometimes, some of them, you know, take 1 hour to burn the coal. It has to be red hot for you to do barbecue. Chicken and sausages and boo. But that's all the good part. The tough part is to burn that coal. That's very difficult. You see? When God picks up people, God does not only pick you up for you to be used, but God is going to trigger something in you. And I want to tell you that something that God triggers is that zeal for you to love God. Amen. We gotta be excited people. There are no grumpy faces in a Christian life. Say amen.
Amen.
It's a song, yeah? So, Yeah, I'm going through the storms in my life. I'm going through the situation in my life. Oh my goodness, it's checkmate. It's so difficult. Brother, you don't know what you're saying. I'm going through the problem. You don't know what I'm going through. Excuse me. Whatever problem you're going through, the joy of the Lord is my strength. So you know what? Even if I'm going through the toughest situation in my life, I know I am practically going through that problem, but that problem no longer harasses me. That problem no longer gives me sleepless nights. That problem no longer stresses my mind and causes fights at home. You know why? Because the joy of the Lord is your strength. I come to church, although I have a tough week, last week was tough, but I come to church excited. If you're not excited, I'm going to tell you today what God is going to do to you to make you excited. You see, we always want our children to look excited. Yeah? Sometimes when the children are not at home, the house is very quiet. I feel something is wrong with this house. When they come, they Oh my goodness, they come. You see, that's why Jesus says you've got to be like little children if you want to enter the kingdom of God. I think a lot of attributes are there with that. We've got to be like a childlike. The Bible says David, in spite of being a king, he danced like a child. That man was passionate, he was crazy for God. Bible is saying that zeal is very, very important. Zeal with knowledge, not without knowledge. So we're going to understand few more scriptures and then we will deal with zeal and knowledge and we'll understand what is it all about, what is this combination all about. We'll pick up Galatians 1, chapter 13. Paul is talking about his past life. We'll just read a little bit of what he's saying. Galatians 1, verse 13. Can somebody read that? You have heard my former conduct in Judaism. How I persecuted the church of God. Beyond measure and try to destroy it. Now we'll stop here. If you read a little more ahead, you will see Paul's former life. You know what Paul was. He was formerly called Saul. And we know a little bit about his life because he says a little bit about what he was. He was a zealous guy. Or a zealous guy. How you pronounce it? I'll say zealous. A zealous, zealous guy. He was so in fire that he was going into people's house and driving Christians out of the house and beating them up, stoning them up, burning them. I don't know how many Christians he might have killed before he became Paul. He's saying that he was moved with a zeal. When I think about this, you also can think, relate, no? Sometimes we see a lot of anti-Christian elements in our society. For them to just slap you is nothing. Because they are so much in zeal. They're so much in zeal, they're hot. I mean they're not on fire. But they're hot. You tell them to do anything, they will go and do it. Even they will risk their life. So Paul is saying that, you know, you remember my former conduct, what I was. But he's saying, you know what? That was zeal. But that was zeal without knowledge. In Romans 10, he talks about the people of Israel. He says, you know what, they have zeal, but no knowledge. And then he clarifies, what is the knowledge that is required for us to go hand in hand with zeal and with knowledge? You need to understand a little bit about zeal. Let me just give you a little definition about zeal before we go ahead. And then we go to the more scriptures. What is zeal? The Greek word for zeal is zelos, Z-E-L-O-S, zelos. What does it mean? It means heat. It means fervent mind. Where we got the word jealousy or zelos. Fervent mind, hot. The Greek word zeo, that's the verb form, fervent. Act 18:25, somebody picked that up really quick. Acts chapter 18 verse 25. This man has been instructed in the way of the Lord and be fervent in spirit. He spoke and taught accurately the things of the Lord. Though he knew the baptism of John only. Who is this man? Apollos. Wonderful, strong man. Man to man with Paul. Of course, Paul was his father in terms of knowledge, but he was no less. The Bible says he was fervent in spirit. It's a very good sign of a believer. It's a very good sign of a... Remember Revelation, the lukewarm church? He said, if you're hot, you better be either hot or cold. Because if you're not either one, then what the Lord is going to do? He'll spit you out. So, don't be cold. That's cold in spirit. We are talking about zeal. But I want to help you. I want to challenge you to understand this. If you want to do something for the Lord, and if you don't have a zeal for the Lord, you can't do anything. You need to have a zeal for God. You need to be fervent in spirit. You need to be hot for the Lord. It's not only when you go for big crusades and then I'm, you know, in heaven, in top five place, and I can survive for the next 3 days. I'm excited for the Lord. Hallelujah. It's even after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, that fervent of that ferventness of that spirit has to still be there. We've got to be fervent in spirit. You see, in the letters, Paul talks about this often. He talks about be fervent in the spirit. Be fervent in the spirit. Be zealous for God. Be zealous for God. Hallelujah. What else? In some other meanings I will tell you about zeal. It says to be hot, boil off, like a liquid boiling, glow, earnest, fervent. When you're in zeal, you're hot, boiling, glowing, earnest and fervent in serving the Lord. Hallelujah. Christians, people always say, ye thanda ho gaya, thanda ho gaya, 5 saal ke baad gaya ho, thanda, anda kunda, thanda, thanda ho gaya. Matlab, when I accepted the Lord, I was in fire. Whew. Nobody could come close to me. I remember when I accepted the Lord, it took me a lot of time, but I will tell you how I got zeal in me. I will tell you in the later part of the content. But when I accepted the Lord, I was so much in zeal. I was into rock music and I had all the collection of rock music. You call it Iron Maiden, Def Leppard, Def Leppard. I got all these collections and I bought new expensive ones. I used to work when I was, you know, when I was studying, and I used to earn a lot of money. I used to spend money on music. You know what? Spend money. One day I came to know about rock music is not good. Backmasking. It talked all about saving worship. What I did, I was so much in zeal. I had no knowledge. I had not had too much of knowledge. Because you know why I had not had knowledge? Because I hardly used to read the word of God. But I was excited. Wow! This is going to be a happening thing. So I went to all, you know, I was staying in Mullen, near St. Pius, a Catholic area. I went to all my friends. I had a good football crowd, friends and all. All along here, guys, doing all this rock music stuff. And I told them, listen, you know what? I found out something you want to hear. I took them, I told them, hear this out. And the day I heard it, I took all the rock music, the ribbons of that, I removed it and I burned it behind my building. After I burned, I started... But then I went to them, I said, you know, you got to do it. They only started burning this. We came out to the area, we started burning, and then I told him, you know what, Jesus is the only answer. What we are doing over here is completely wrong. You guys are all going to hell. I hope there is no Catholics over here. I'm not offending you. But I'm telling you what I was when, I'm telling you my testimony. Don't get offended. And they said, yes, even they also believe it. That's a good part. Easy, George. I think this is easy stuff, yeah. Christianity is cakewalk. Then what? Next day their father, mother came to my home and they complained to my dad out of everybody. And they told my dad, if your son ever talks to my son again, I'll put him behind bars. Then you know what happened after that? My dad gave me a nice, strong lecture. If you do this, you will be out of the house. Zeal, that hotness. Is that zeal still there today? I think about it a lot. Wow, that zeal was good. Lord said it was good, but it was without knowledge. Lord said now it's better because now you have zeal and with knowledge. Hallelujah. It's very important that you control your excitement level. As human beings, psychologically, we get excited for everything. You see a Shah Rukh Khan dance over there. Wow, yeah, kya nacha. You hear some good music. This music is good. Excited. When you hear some, Hollywood, Bollywood music, you know, your foot starts tapping automatically. Ooh, wow. Ooh, ooh, ooh. That's excitement. As human beings, we get excited. You get a new job offer, you want to jump over the job because wow, it's an offer, I will take it. Excitement, zeal is good. It's there in all of us. But I'm telling you friends, your zeal is good, but it is not good without knowledge. People in Hosea, it says in Hosea chapter 4, I think it says over there, my people perish due to lack of knowledge. We need to know what is knowledge. But before we get into knowledge, I want you to really understand more about zeal. Okay. Romans 10 chapter 2. If you read ahead over there, we all read that. I can assure you that they are deeply devoted to God, but their devotion is not based on true knowledge. Their devotion is not based on true knowledge. Now there are so many festivals coming in India this next quarter. You see the way they are. My, they're still zealous for their God. They'll do anything. You see a Christian so zealous for his God? A Christian also has to be so excited. Are my God of Israel, how dare you? Last time I was so encouraged by some testimonies of some church members who came forward and said, you know what, I stopped saying God, I started saying Jesus. That's good. That's good stuff. In the office I'm praying now, people are recognizing me as I'm praying. That's good. Because they're excited, they cannot keep there. But at the moment, at the same time with their zeal, they also have knowledge because they know they need to pray. Zeal is very, very important in our lives. And we need to be fervent in God. We need to be fervent in our spirits. Romans 12:11. Somebody pick that verse up. Romans 12:11.
Not lacking in diligence, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord.
Hallelujah. See, you sir, I told you the meaning of zeal is also fervent, hot. Wherever you see fervent in spirit, they're talking about zeal. Romans says that, Romans 12, work hard and do not be lazy. Serve the Lord with a heart full of devotion. In another version. Be fervent in the spirit. It's like, you know, when you're reading the Bible in the morning, you're excited about it. You get excited to open that Bible and read. Then you know that you have to pray. You're excited to pray. It's in you. That's zeal. That getting excited for the Lord. We've got to be excited for the Lord. Zeal encourages and stimulates others. You be with a zealous man, you also will be a zealous person. You will get highly motivated being with such people. But if you don't be with such people, the problem is the chances of you being zealous also is very, very less. You've got to choose your friends who are zealous. There are some people who are very zealous, but zealous for the wrong things. I'll come to that point again. Zeal is an identifying mark of God's special people. Hallelujah. In another verse it says, He gave Himself for us that He might redeem us from all iniquity and purify us Himself, a peculiar people, zealous of good works. We got to be zealous of doing good things, not thinking of doing bad. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 2. It's a very beautiful thing over there. Just take a look at that verse. 2 Corinthians, even I'll turn it. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 2. You need to often read this passage now. This is a very beautiful passage that talks about zeal. We are talking about zeal, okay? Chapter 9 verse 2. I'll read from verse 1. Now concerning the ministering to the saints, it is superfluous for me to write to you. For I know your willingness about which I boast of you to the Macedonians, that Achaia was ready a year ago and your zeal has stirred up the majority. Stop there. Your zeal has stirred up the majority. You see, if your zeal is for the Lord with knowledge, you come to church, you are going to help others also to be zealous for God. Because you have zeal with knowledge and somebody has zeal without knowledge, that zeal without knowledge person would not be able to rub on you because you got zeal with knowledge. Your zeal is not a counterfeit zeal. Your zeal is not a temporary zeal. Your zeal is not something that you are only excited when the situation comes in your life. Bible says, you know, give thanks to God in all circumstances. Hallelujah. So, if you don't have a job, you're jobless, you're going through a financial loss, give thanks to God. You don't wait for a happy moment in your life to say thank you, Lord. Even if the situation in your house is tough and challenging, you got to say thank you, Lord. That is zeal. You're zealous for God. Whether it is a good thing or a bad thing, you're zealous for God. And it says over here, it says Paul is writing that your zeal has stirred up the majority, and because of your zeal, many people have done the same thing. You read the content later, go home and read it. The zeal of God is powerful. It's also contagious, by the way. It spreads like wildfire. You know, you go to a crusade, if you see one person jumping and dancing, the second person will go to an I'll jump and dance. Third person, even I'll jump and dance. Even I'll jump and dance. Zeal is not actually about physical movement. Zeal is not about physical movement. Yes, but it stirs up action. Faith without action is dead. Zeal without action is no zeal. If you have zeal in you, you got to have action in you. I cannot say that I'm excited for the Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah, and you're doing nothing for the Lord. You're only talking about this for years. 5 years have gone. How many years in the Lord, brother? 6 years? How many years? Sure, you say, you know, I've been in the Lord since I was born. Born. Born to be there. There? Nobody knows. But you know, you're the same person. You're the same, talking the same old childish stuff in Christian. You don't want to grow. You don't want to take a chance. You don't want to walk with the Lord. You don't want to be zealous for God. That's the problem. We've got to be zealous for God. Hallelujah. And you know who takes advantage of this? When you're zealous, Satan tries to undermine our zeal by telling us we are just trying to promote ourselves. But Paul wrote to the Galatians in Galatians 4:18, it is good to be zealously affected always in a good thing. Good to be zealous, effective in a good thing. So Satan comes and says, no, you're trying to promote yourself, you're getting excited now, people are, you're grabbing attention. Don't go by that lie. You're excited for the Lord, let your excitement continue, my friends. Let the fire of the Lord burn in you. Hallelujah. Amen. Zeal doesn't require one to be righteous, over-righteous. You don't have to be over-righteous to be zealous for God. You don't have to be over-righteous. Oh, ye brother hamesha meeting ke liye aata hai, hamesha church mein aata hai. Very nice. That doesn't mean he's zealous for God. Having zealous for the Lord, being zealous for the Lord is not about being over-righteousness. You're not going to be like a Pharisee. The Pharisee was there, they were full of zeal. Always ready for action. They used to always challenge Jesus, counter Jesus. Oh, you tell me this, this law, this law, this law, this law, this law. They always counter-attacked Jesus. They were full of zeal. but for the wrong things. What is zeal? Zeal is a recognition that we all have responsibilities and jobs in the Lord's kingdom, and the desire to do our own individual and special part. What is zeal? That we have a responsibility and we have to have a desire to do our part in the kingdom of God. God blesses you, you grow in the Lord, you become marriageable age, you get married, after marriage you get children, after children you get busy in their life and building the children's life. That's not the only thing that God wants you to be dwelling in. In all of this activity you do, you got to still be zealous for the Lord. You got to be ready to do something for the Lord. Hallelujah. And I want to take you to an important thing. How do I increase my zeal for God? How do I increase my zeal for God? Let me come into knowledge a little while. But here is very carefully. You may say, okay, but brother, what do I do now? How do I stir up my spirit? How do I get excited for the Lord? There are many people who got knowledge, but they are not zealous for God. That's useless. Oh, this guy is too good. He's got too much of knowledge, but he's not zealous for God. What do you mean by not being zealous for God? He's not excited for the Lord. For example, you know what? When somebody comes in office and tells you, you know what, there's a problem in my house. You're not excited at all to tell that Jesus can solve the problem in your house. There is no excitement in you. In your society, when there is a discussion going on and you are a part of the discussion, you are acting like them instead of acting like Christ. That is not exciting. That is not zeal. That is not zeal. If you call that zeal, then that is zeal without knowledge. You are just being zealous for no reason. Some people are so excited that they know scriptures by heart. By heart they know scriptures. How many people know scriptures by heart? No, I'm not saying it's not good. How many people know scriptures by heart? I know. I know a lot of scriptures by heart. But does that make me zealous for God? No, that doesn't make me zealous for God. Knowing the scripture and applying them is what makes me zealous for God. Because I'm excited. I'm hearing something, I want to do what the Lord wants me to do. I'm reading something and I'm doing what God wants me to do. That is being zealous for God. But how do I increase this zeal for God? God wants us to be zealous. He wants us to be zealous for Him. He wants us to be excited for Him. Always be excited. But how do I increase His excitement now? That's a big question mark. People say, no, ek baar baith gaya, woh baith gaya. You have to actually push somebody. Come on, go, go. Sometimes you have to push him out of the house. Go, go, get out, go do something to the Lord. Yes, okay. And you know what? What we do? We say, no, we want to do, yeah, we want. Let's get in the sofa, on the couch. Haan, karega na, karega. God ke liye karega. They sat for 10 minutes, after 10 minutes they will drink water. Karega na? Karega. Aaram se. Time hai na, kidhar yaar, why are you taking so much tension? Karega na, kal hai na time. Then Bible and they put their shoes very slow motion. Karega na, Prabhu ke liye karega na. Karega. You remove money from the pocket. Dega na yaar, kya hai, tension kya? Dega na. Somebody tells in the house, "Arey, kuch karo yaar, kuch nahi kiya abhi tak, karega na." The Lord will provide. That all we know very well. Sounds very nice, no? In the movies you hear, the movie nice, dramatic and sound and all backgrounds on. The Lord will provide. Yeah. Then we go out and travel by bus. Karega na? Time hai. Pehle kaam pe jayega. Roti, kapda, aur. By the makkal ne likha hai, only roti kapra. I'm telling the truth. Jesus says, seek ye first the and is very good. That's a very important word, righteousness. And all, not it's not written all will be added up. Everybody says, thank you Lord, I seek you first, the kingdom of God and righteousness, and everything I will get, Lord. Thank you. God doesn't say that. God says, roti or kapra, food on clothing. One man came to Jesus very excited. Lord, no, I want to follow you, Lord. Come in, mark a little. One man came to Jesus. Lord, I want to follow you, Lord. Lord, fire. zeal. I remember that zeal. I was also like that once upon a time. Then what Jesus said? Jesus became a poet over there. Foxes have holes, birds have nests, but the Son of God has no place to lay his head. What a poem. Rhyming also. Now, I don't know what that guy did. After that, there was no mention about the guy. Then he U-turn market hai. Where? If I have to follow someone, that person has to be established, no? Top class. Gold chain, bracelets, Mercedes car, good bungalow. With that guy, maybe thought his mind is famous because Jesus became very famous during that time, no? He was one personality. Oh! If there was CNN and all, Jesus' interview was on every channel. He was so famous. He was so famous. Our Lord is very famous, by the way. He's still famous. You know what? And but when people think he's famous, toh bada aadmi rahega. Hey, kuch dam hai usme. Dam toh bahut hai. But the problem is he doesn't have the guts to follow. Zeal without knowledge is very dangerous. Are you zealous for God? Are you excited for God? Or do you need somebody to always push you? करो ना प्रभु के लिए कुछ करो ना करो ना करो ना करो करू 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 पांच साल गया ऐसा वेस्ट कुछ नहीं किया प्रभु के लिए ऐसे सोचते गया यू नो व्हेन यू हैव ज़ील फॉर गॉड हियर मी वेरी केयरफुली व्हेन यू हैव ज़ील फॉर गॉड लाइक वन एक्यूजर ऑफ द ब्रदर द डिस्ट्रॉयर द डेविल विल कम एंड स्नैच अवे दैट ज़ील फॉर योर लाइफ यू नो इफ योर ज़ील इज फॉर गॉड यू कैन डू anything for God. You can go in front of those anti-Christian elements and say, I believe in Jesus. Get out. You don't have the guts to do that. I'm not saying do that. But when a scenario comes tomorrow like this, are we going to turn back or are we going to stand for the Lord? Do we have the guts to say this? You know, when we have a family get together, all your family members come, they don't know Lord only, nothing they know about Jesus. They think you're mad because you know Jesus. They think you're mad. And then they talk about these things. Do you have the guts at that point to say, sorry, I believe in Jesus. Unko vishwas karne ka mat karo, main karta hu. Talk in respect for my Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Excitement, zealous. Nobody can, you know, fiddle with your zeal because that's too dangerous. The zeal of God has consumed me. It burns within my soul. A mighty force that cannot be stopped, a fire that cannot be quenched. How do I increase this zeal? You might say, no, but brother, how do I get excited for God? You want to hear that? How do you get excited for God? Number one, how do I get excited for the Lord? What do I do? First thing, stay away from things that defocuses or distracts you from the Lord. First thing, what do you do? Stay away from things that defocuses you and distracts you from the Lord. Peter was walking on the water. He was focused on the Lord. But the storms came. Defocus. He started drowning. He's a fisherman. Huh? He can't drown. But he started drowning. You see how terrible the storm can be in your life. You know what to do in that situation, but your mind is no longer working. Because your focus has been distracted. You have to focus on the Lord Jesus. Stay away from things. Your work, if you're earning too much, that's good. Praise God, earn more. But if that money is getting in the way of your time with the Lord, please think about it. Search for another job. God will provide you. Say, Lord, this is coming between you and me. I cannot take it, Lord. God said, good, I'll get you another job. Somebody say, Amen. You're working and it's over stress, over pressure, overtime and all that stuff. Be careful. You're coming home, you're getting tired, you're going eating your food and going to sleep. You're not even having the time to spend with the Lord. I'm not even coming to the church and praying until now. I'm only talking your personal time with the Lord. Is anything coming in between your personal time with the Lord? The problem. Okay, I'm watching football matches. I love to watch football. I watch football matches. But if I watch football match every day and full day I keep watching only matches, movies, but at the end I give only 10 minutes for the Lord, tell me, is it fair? full day you have done all your time pass, majagiri, tab kiya. At the end of the day, you are giving 10 minutes for God, be ashamed of yourself. Galatians 2:20, we don't take part in the Lord's Supper because it's some tradition. We don't take part in the Lord's Supper because we are supposed to take part, holy, holy. No! Galatians 2:20 says, I have been crucified with Christ, I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. Christ lives in me. You're spending 10 minutes every day. When God created Adam and Eve, God said nothing during Adam and Eve. I'm going to walk with you every day. God wanted to spend time with His creation every day. The maximum time God wanted to fellowship with them. We have to learn to do that. You want to be excited in the Lord, my friend, there are no shortcuts. You've got to work hard for it. You've got to do something about it. Stay away from things that distract you. Your friends are calling you every time out. Society meetings and society picnics and whatnot, and you don't have time for the Lord, stay away from the people. Nothing should come in between your personal time with the Lord. Don't tell me that when I'm traveling, I'm spending time with God. That is nonsense. Huh? That is extra time. Thank you, only one amen. That is extra time. Nay, brother, I came home late, working very hard. Oh, now I'm driving. I have no time, brother, what to do? Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, everything okay? Break, Maro. Lord, I'm fine with you. Left, Maro. Green signal. You're talking like that with the Lord. You're talking like that with the Lord. Is that your personal time of meditation? I'm saying that's good. Talk. That's good. It's a good habit. But that's not your personal time of meditation. Sorry. You cannot make things communal according to your convenience. That is not your personal time. If you want to be zealous for God, get ready. God is going to trigger excitement in you. But don't get into these things that distracts you from the Lord. Second thing. If you want to increase God's zeal in you, hear this carefully. If you want to increase God's zeal in you, you must decrease the world's zeal in you. Remember Jesus says, two legs in two boats. You want balance of us? Some people are very good. They are still balancing for the last 10 minutes. Some people are balancing for 2 years. I'm balancing, balancing. No, you'll fall. I'm telling you, you'll fall. There are some people say, no, I'm balancing for the last 10 years, but I know how to balance. I become a master in balancing. You become master, but you're zero. There is no way, there's no zeal in you. You're not going anywhere with the Lord. If you are excited too much of the things of the world, you got to drop that little bit. Drop that little bit. Drop by 2%, 10%. Thoda usko kam karo. Because if you don't do that, my friends, your zeal for God will never increase. Your zeal for God will never. You cannot be excited. No, Lord, I won't be excited there also. I won't be excited here also. No, you can't. God said, choose what you want, life or death. Take it, leave it. Take it or leave it. Number three, if you want to, this is what happened to me. When I accepted the Lord, I was zealous for God, but zero in Bible. Kuch nahi malum tha Bible. Kaun hai, kya Bible, pata nahi. Bible is lying somewhere, dusted somewhere. Sometimes I open, you know, it just open like this. Lord, you know what? I want a verse. Ha! Hallelujah. That verse, what? Doesn't make any sense to me. I just read. Bible pada na, verse. That was me when I accepted the Lord. But you know what? One thing what I liked, I knew very well that Jesus was the way, the truth and the life. There was no doubt about it. That I knew from my heart. But I knew that Bible is going. And you know what? One thing that caught my zeal, I never missed a prayer meeting or a church service. Whoa! I'm telling you, when I think about it now, and I say, Lord, yes, maybe that could be the key that got my excitement up. Never missed a prayer meeting. I was always there. Even if I could not do it, I would say, I'll do it. And I go there and it's all flop. But I managed to be there. But I'm zealous. I was zealous for God. Because without knowledge, till then. But then, for me to increase that zeal, I never missed a prayer meeting or a church service. You need to make that your top priority. VVVIP, top confidence, priority. Come what may, I will not miss fellowshipping with God's people. Hallelujah. That's the third one. Number four. Very important if you want to increase your zeal for God. Number four, find out your calling and begin to work on it. Find out your, look at each other and say, I have a calling. You know why we do that? Why you have a calling? Every one of you, God says, you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a pet. You will go out in the dark and pull people like how you fish, no? In the you take a rod and you take the fish out of the water, like that you all will be. You will fish people from the darkness into the light. You'll drop a fake and you'll pick people. Hurry, flight catcher, come. You are so special, you are so privileged, my friends, so privileged. Don't mess up. Don't mess up. What is this? Find out your calling. Somebody of you over here is an evangelist. Somebody of you over here are a prophet. You know, you are a teacher of the word of God. You realize that? You ever found out that? Somebody of you, God has called you to administer. Somebody, God has called you to do something for the kingdom of God. Tell me one person in this room who doesn't have a calling for God. Everybody has a calling. You don't have a calling, meet me after the service. I pray for you and I will tell you what's your calling. You have a calling for God. God has picked you because he called you something for him. These children sitting over there, all of them, God already knows their calling here. Forget you, you're a parent. The child, so God has picked, this child is going to grow and I'm going to make her a prophetess, a prophet, a teacher of the word, a pastor. God has called people for the ministry. Do you recognize your calling for the Lord? I've been always telling this to everybody. Do you know your calling? Do you know what God has called you for? Do you know? No, brother, I'm still thinking. What are you thinking? If God has given you a calling, God will tell you what's your calling. God will not tell you after you become old. No, brother, there is time. What, after 80 years? Then you come. Brother, 80 years of age, I know my calling. No, God will never do that. Yeah, God will never do that. You pick up people in the Bible. You check this, foolproof. Pick up people from the Bible. God picked up young to young people. David, who was David? He was a shepherd boy. He was in his teens maybe. Yeah. David. The teenagers are here. God has picked the teenagers. God has picked teenagers to kill Goliath. Yeah. Forget everybody. God doesn't need anybody. Hallelujah. God has a calling for you. If you recognize your calling, if you know your calling, please try to work on it. Start working. Come to me. Tell me, Pastor, this is what I call. I'll put you in that job because that's your calling. You will build in that work. You will build in that ministry. Praise and worship is not a calling. You're playing guitar and singing and all. That's not calling. That is good. Praise God. God has blessed you with talents. That's nice. Tomorrow we'll have new musicians. We'll have new singers. Fantastic. The people who are there, they will move on and do something else for the Lord. Say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We are here to serve the Lord, to build God's church. These young boys and, you know, these our kids, they are all future musicians. They are all going to come up. You see, you have learned guitaring now. These kids are going to learn guitar even before that. And you'll see them. Are they calling Chintu here? Once I went to one meeting, I went to one big meeting. I was in the drum. I don't know how he reached the pedals of it. I think they must have made something special for him. The way he was playing, oh my goodness me. If God can use David, God can use anybody. You've got to be excited for the Lord, friends. God can use you like anything. Don't underestimate God. Number five. We have time. Go look at the watch. We have time. Read lives of people who have zeal for God. You know, you like to read books? Pick up books about missionaries who are zealous for God. Pick up the Bible. Pick up characters who are zealous for God. Lord, how is a man who is zealous for you, Lord God? Read what he did, why he was so. If you read such books, no? your zeal will be pepped up a little bit more. Number six, engage in doing some work for the church. If you want your zeal to increase, what you got to do? Engage yourself in some work of the church. Come and tell your leaders in the house to leader, you know, brother, meko ye karnega, meko ye karnega, me karega, me karega, me karega. Tumko nahi malum hai, phir bhi karo. God will teach you how to do it. Don't worry, God will provide everything for you. God is a great God. Yeah. But don't come to church and go like that Sunday to Sunday to Sunday. Do some work for the church. And we need somebody to arrange chairs. Anybody want to come in the morning to arrange chairs? Do some work for the church. We need people to pick up these things, to pick up this, to plug in the wiring. We need people. Where are you? 8:15 in the morning. Come, do something for the church. You're busy during the week, I understand. But Sunday, give the Lord, no. Work for the church. I'm telling you, when I first came to the church, I was, my only ministry was to clean the chairs with a cloth. Wow, I enjoyed it. Because that was the easiest church. No going in front of people. I was very afraid to go in front of people. So I used to come early, quickly put the chair by. Ready. I did that faithfully for years and years. After that, somewhere down the line, God told me, now it's time for you to try to sing some songs. And that's when I started singing songs, and that's when I got into praise worship after that. Do some work for... There is nothing shame, huh? Nothing to be shy. Today also, there is nobody to put the chair. No, I'll put the chairs. I'll wipe the chair. There is nothing to be shy. It's for the Lord. It's a big privilege here. Hallelujah. It's a blessing to do for the Lord. We need somebody to put these banners up. We need help. Who's going to do it? You want to increase your zeal? This is another way. Come no early in the morning. What is there? Agar darwaza band hai, tumhi chalega na. Wait not till the door gets open. What is there? Zealous for God. Hallelujah. Number seven, allow the Spirit of God to lead you and be completely dependent on the Holy Spirit. That's the only way you will trigger your sin. Hallelujah. Bible says, you know, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Jesus said, you know what? I send you a comforter. I send you a counselor. He's going to guide you in all the truth. He's going to help you everywhere in your life. Today, who's helping you? The power that is within you. Which is the power? The Holy Spirit that is within you. Jesus is seated at the right hand of God. But He sent His Holy Spirit to help you and me. Whenever you're in office, you're stuck, just say one small line. Oh, sweet Spirit of God, I need your help. Please come and change. You won't believe the miracle that it's going to do. You just have to believe that the Holy Spirit will work in you. He's there with you. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to earn for anything. Just say, you know, Benny Hinn wrote one book long time back, Good Morning Holy Spirit. It's personalized. The Holy Spirit is a person. It's not it. It's a person. You respect Him. You revere Him. You honor Him. You're going with your friends outside. Be careful, because the Holy Spirit is with you, in you. It's not only with you, but it's in you. It's amazing, right? We're powerful people. I'm telling you, we are all one nuclear bomb sitting here. Oh God, you know, better than that. The Holy Spirit is in you. Amen. Are you excited? In me? Yes, in me, in you. The Holy Spirit. Greater is He that is in me than He that is in the world. We do not fear anybody or any nonsense. Because God has not given us a spirit of fear, but God has given us a spirit of power, love, and sound mind. I don't fear anybody. Ha! Who cares? My God is there. Hallelujah! Even Joshua agrees with that. Right. Finally, and the last, and we'll end over here. We'll come to knowledge maybe next Sunday. Number eight. Very, very important. This is one biggest problem. When I was sitting with the Lord and was like jotting down these points, I said, Lord, yeah, this is the biggest problem. Number eight, the last but not the least. Rebuke the spirit of shame and rebuke the spirit of fear. Because I'm sitting on this chair, I want to lift my hand, but I will not, because I'm very, very, I'm very, you know, conscious about people. I want to talk about my Lord in the office, but I'm too scared. Oh, I want to pray in front of unbelievers, but I'm feeling very shy. This is going to be a biggest stumbling block for you to increase your zeal for the Lord.
David overcame it. As a king, just think about it. As a king, born shepherd boy, days are over. Now he's become king. Maharaj. Maharaj ki jai ho. He's not caring. Kaun Maharaj, kiska Maharaj. He was dancing. The music was going on. He was dancing before the Lord. Like a child, the Bible says. I don't know what he must have done. He must have jumped like a child. It was something he did funny. People were laughing. Ha ha. But who cares? He is not caring on you. He was not even looking at people. He was dancing like a child. Look, I'm not saying that to have a zeal for God, you got to keep dancing every day. Zeal. No, that is not zeal, my friends. God wants you to be a fire for Him. You got to be burning for the Lord. Burning forever. Excited for God. You're going out of church, you're still excited. Yeah. Church mein gaya, baba, excitement tha, achha, maza aaya. But bahar gaya, phir bhi excited hai. You're going home, you have to cook food, it's become late, but you're excited for the Lord. Something happened today evening at home. Arre yaar, abhi church mein gaya, morning day kabhi jagda ho gaya. Get excited for the Lord. Hallelujah, Lord! I'm not going to get depressed. I'm not going to be ashamed. I'm not going to get scared, Lord. There are problems in life, you have to face it, that's the truth. But God has given us the greatest thing to overcome that problem, and that is Jesus. That's the Holy Spirit in you. Hallelujah. So we just pray. Father in heaven, we thank you and we bless you, Lord, for this time.